America's crime crisis.
Come on, man, stop. Stop, man. Leave it, man. Stop, man, please.
Stop
please.
Resisting.
No, stop, please, man. Please stop, man. I don't want to
I won't resist.
I don't want to get in jail.
Police body cam footage showing the dramatic arrest of a Target shoplifter in Atlanta, Georgia. The guy got caught red-handed trying to steal a $500 TV, and it wasn't small either. Sadly, scenes like this are the new normal in our country. A recent New York Times op-ed, quote, "What we lose to shoplifting is pointing out the awful toll theft takes on average workers who have to deal with this stuff on a daily basis." Quote, "Most people who work in stores expect to fold shirts, restock shelves, handle customer requests, not confront brazen and sometimes hostile shoplifters or organized theft rings. Working in an environment in which shoplifting is prevalent is stressful and can be traumatizing, you think? But it's not all sympathy from the media. Another outlet is trying to shame stores who lock up their merchandise." Check out this insanity from the LA Times titled, quote, "Grocery stores used to be my happy place. Then they started locking up the detergent." Quote, "Businesses in supplying social contact need our support, but they also bear social responsibility. Those that make their customers pay a psychological cost every time we purchase a gallon of milk, we will lose money as we start shopping elsewhere." My hair hurts from reading that. This is brazen. David, what happened in Atlanta? Let's stop there first before we go to
first
insanity.
Of all, yes. Are you sure that first story was in the New York Times? Because they're usually blaming the business and everybody else in a bad upbringing.
That was refreshing from the old gray.
Yeah.
No question. Your happy place, a grocery store? Anyway.
Yeah, I know. My happy place is maybe the gun range.
but brazen, right? I mean, the guy's walking around with 65-inch TV.
Brazen's not only the word here, yeah. But think about it. He went once, and he came back for more. So was it really a surprise that he ran to a police officer? But there's a problem here in Atlanta, which you have the prosecutors and you have the left-wing judges. You have the prosecutors like Fannie Willis and others who support all of these lax on crime policies. And the mayor, when you look at Atlanta, it's sad because Atlanta's a city that's on the teetering edge of failure. If they don't stop this, if they don't arrest him on the first time, not the second time, then look at San Francisco, look at Los Angeles. Now in San Francisco, businesses are closing as we speak, and people are trying to protect themselves as night falls.
Atlanta, homicides are up for the third straight year. Burglaries, shoplifting, car thefts. It used to be a great city, right? But again, it's the same thing over and over again, Lisa, where you have district attorneys who don't enforce the law, so people like this end up going back out into the street. This guy thought he was going to walk out with a 65-inch TV,
twice,
and was shocked that he was getting stopped. That's where we are in this country at this point. Twice, thank you.
So I've got a crazy idea.
Yeah.
If we locked up the shoplifters, you wouldn't have to lock up the goods. But anyways, so I think you know, we've got to ask ourselves this question. You know, how did we become a country where so many Americans feel entitled to steal? And obviously, we've seen crime waves in past in this country. But I think what we can trace back what we're seeing now to Michael Brown, right? You had a guy go into a store, steal cigars, shove the clerk, then go and proceed to try to pull the police officer's
Ferguson,
gun
we're
in Ferguson.
Right.
Michael Brown, hands up, don't shoot Ferguson. And then you had the media and the left go out and say that he was the victim when he was the criminal. And you still have people like Rep. Cori Bush saying that he died because of white supremacy, even though Obama's Department of Justice proved otherwise that Michael Brown was in the wrong. So how do we have a functioning society in that environment?
Anita.
Yeah.
I want you to react to this.
Okay.
The San Francisco Chronicle. And they have a really good idea. They say crime is so bad near the San Francisco Federal Building, employees are told to work from home.
Wow.
So instead, we're throwing the white flag of surrender. All right, you know what, guys? We can't solve this. Just work from home. How about the person who works at Walgreens and they have to work there to survive? Can they work from home while they're seeing shoplifters go left and right and then they have to confront them once in a while if need be?
Well, they can't work at Walgreens anymore because they're closing because of all the crime. They
great
can't
point.
Stay open,
yes.
Right? You know, can I go back to this Atlanta situation for a moment? Because it's just so bizarre that this guy was walking out with a television, right? it's not his fault. Because he's watching all these other people on the news get away with these crimes. Mm-hmm. There's no law enforcement. And he thinks, well, it must be okay. I can walk out with a huge television set. It's not just, you know, stuff it in your pocket, stuff it down your shirt. I'm walking out with a television because it's acceptable now.
Yeah.
Yeah. And real quick, to the LA Times opinion there. Okay. Sorry. This assistant professor who wrote that article, she was shopping in Oakland, in Rockridge. That's a very affluent section. People there, the average income is over $200,000. And, you know, she's complaining about things being locked up. I thought that was quite interesting.
Wow.
She needs to get out more.
Yeah,
I mean, if grocery shopping is her happy place, like, you need hobbies, lady. Go find something more fun to do. Get a
hang
life.
Out with Lisa.
Yeah, well, no, I don't want to. No. I'll hang out with you anyway.
Right?
I'm not hanging out with that lady. She sounds miserable.
Great discussion, everybody.
We'll go someplace that's not the grocery store.
Sounds good.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.